Mandamos nuestras saludos y oraciones también a tu madre y María Vida. She's with us too, in spirit, we know that. And truly, God, in his providence, has brought us all here together for your ordination as a deacon. As you continue your studies and your vocational journey to the priesthood, we take this time for you, todos nosotros, to have an encounter, an encuentro con la palabra viviente de Dios, with the living word of God. Your ministry as a deacon will be marked by service at the altar and with care for others, word and charity, under the Acts of the Apostles. The readings that you have chosen for this day give us a clue for you to live that vocation of service to the fullest extent the Lord asks you. Reflecting on the book of Numbers, we can think and remember that in your choice to follow the Lord, to become to this moment, your calling as a deacon is ultimately God, la llamada de Dios. All of us may think sometimes that in some way our vocational choices are our ideas, our inspiration, nuestros ideas. In verdad, en algún nivel es la verdad. At some level it's true. But in the end, it is the call of God to seek and to follow. It is the call of God how we are chosen. The same dynamic is also in the case of the Acts of the Apostles, where the first deacons were chosen. Jose, you are chosen by the Lord in the same manner as those first deacons in the pages of the Acts of the Apostles. Y su misión is to help the Word of God continue to spread, as Acts says, to continue to spread in this rather confusing world. Finally, as they reflecting on our lives and my life at times, we all have a tendency to have many concerns, be worried and preoccupied. However, the gospel is clear for us all. Y también mañana muy especial y por usted, beloved brother, to trust in God's providence and to care, providence and care, who will guide you all the circumstances of your life and ministry, wherever your life goes. How much then will he provide for you, Jose, as he provides the gospel for the lilies of the field? Su vida, su presencia, su vocación must draw people whom you meet, God, really, truly, through the beauty of his love reflected in your life and ministry as the lilies of the field. Finally, just a word of advice from my years of ministry, which reflect our visit this morning in our conversation with Africa. Early on in my ministry, many years ago now, I was blessed to work with folks who recovered from what we call the 12 Step Program. In the foundation of the 12 Steps that leads people to holier and healthier lives is gratitude. Thanksgiving. Gracias. Empieza cada día. Get each day, Jose, with gratitude, as we spoke. Gratitude for your family, your parents, your brothers and sisters, esta comunidad, sus hermanos en comunidad, muchos otros cosas, and many other people. And it's through them you've heard the voice of God. And they will be the voice of God again for you in many unexpected moments. And will teach you again and again, always to be grateful. That message of gratitude, that voice of God will come to you in ministry in unexpected ways. It will teach you again and again, remind you again and again to always begin and frame your life in ministry, and especially your service as a deacon, in word and in sacrament, with gratitude to God for all. Today the church remembers St. Martha, and she will be an example of hospitality for you that you extend to others. Today, as all Saturdays are, dedicated to the Mother of God, and especially this parish here. And debe ser listo siempre para decir sí a cualquier cosa. Say yes to whatever the Lord asks of you. And to be ready to say yes even before you are asked. And finally, we are now at the beginning of July. Now, say we are in view of the great feast of St. Augustine, patron of your community. As he says in his confessions, be always ready to embrace the Lord, who will bring you the strength that you need. By embracing the Lord, the strength of God will be yours. And always do it with love. Because also St. Augustine says, and it's one of my favorite quotes, late how I love you, O beauty of ancient, O beauty of renewal, late how I love you. See, I do not think for you that this call is late, but it is always a call to embrace and receive this call of love for all of us, which is to be the foundation for daily life, especially for your ministry and vocation as a deacon. And finally, as the exhortation says for this day and this liturgy, firmly rooted and grounded in faith, you are to show yourself chaste and beyond reproach before God and man, as is proper for ministers of Christ and of the stewards of God's mysteries. Never allow yourself to be turned away from the hope offered by the gospel. Now you are not only hearer of this gospel, but also its minister. Hold the minister of mystery of faith with a clear conscience, expressed by your actions the word of God which your lips proclaim, that the Christian people brought to life by the Spirit may be a pure offering accepted by God. And on the last day, when you go out to meet the Lord, you will be able to hear him say, well done, good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of the Lord. On this day of joy, we say, may God bless you and your family and your brothers and community. Your son, before you enter the order of the diaconate, you must declare for the people your intention to undertake this office. You resolve to be consecrated for the church's ministry by the laying on of my hands and the gift of the Holy Spirit. You resolve to discharge the office of deacon with humble charity in order to assist the priestly order and to benefit the Christian people. You resolve to hold fast the mystery of faith with a clear conscience, as the apostle urges, and to proclaim this faith in word and deed according to the gospel and the church and tradition. You resolve to keep forever this commitment to remain celibate as a sign of the dedication to Christ the Lord, the sake of the kingdom of heaven, and the service of God and man. You resolve to maintain and deepen the spirit of prayer that is proper to your way of life, and keeping with this spirit and what is required of you, to celebrate faithfully the liturgy of the hours, with and for the people of God and indeed for the whole world. You resolve to conform your way of life always to the example of Christ, whose body and blood you are ministers at the altar. You promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior. May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Mommy.
My dear people, let us pray that God, our powerful Father, will mercifully pour out the grace of his blessing on this, his servant, whom in his kindness he raises to the sacred order of the diaconate. Let us kneel.
Ruega por nosotros. By virtue of our office, sanctified by your blessing, this man we present. For in our judgment, we believe him worthy to exercise sacred ministries through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand. Draw near, we pray, Almighty God, giver of every grace, to apportion every order and assign every office, to remain unchanged and make all things new. In your eternal providence, you make provision for every age. As you order all creation through him who is your word, your power and your wisdom, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. You grant that the church, his body, adorned with manifold heavenly graces, drawn together in this diversity of its members, and united by a wondrous bond through the Holy Spirit, should grow and spread forth to build up a new temple. And as once you have chosen the sons of Levi to minister in the former tabernacle, now you establish three ranks of ministers, their sacred offices to serve your name. And so as in the first days of the church, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, your sons apostles appointed seven men of good repute to assist them in the daily ministry, that they might devote themselves more fully to prayer and preaching of the word. By prayer and the laying on of hands, they entrusted to these chosen men the ministry of serving at table. We beseech you, Lord, look with favor on this servant of yours, who will minister at your holy altar, and whom we now humbly dedicate to the office of deacon. Send forth upon him, Lord, we pray, the Holy Spirit, that he may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace and the faithful carrying out of the work of the ministry. May there abound in him every gospel virtue, unfeigned love, concern for the sick and the poor, unassuming authority, the purity of innocence, and the observance of spiritual discipline. May your commandments shine forth in his conduct, that by the example of his way of life, he may inspire the imitation of your holy people. In offering the witness of a clear conscience, may he remain strong and steadfast in Christ, that by imitating on earth your Son, who came not to be served but to serve, he may be found worthy to reign in heaven with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Teach what you believe and practice what you teach.